We have a wealth of data, and both by we, I mean both the researchers who work with humans and those who work with animals, often rodents or monkeys or beagles, that suggest that staying physically active is neuroprotective. That as a young child, you tend to do better in school, you have a better memory, have a better attention span, you have larger brain regions and more efficient neural networks. And as you get older, individuals who stay physically active tend to be diagnosed at a much lesser rate with age-associated neurodegenerative disorders like Alzheimer's dementia and vascular dementia and other forms of dementia. So physical fitness is certainly one important variable that's useful throughout the lifespan in maintaining high levels of cognition and putting off or at least delaying the onset of some of these age-associated neurodegenerative disorders.
It's fascinating, really, because to be totally coordinated in the moment, to be absolutely coordinated, everything is like on. You know what I mean? It's a really empowering thing. And I know I don't know too much about the physics of it all or anything like that. But I do know that before I started dancing, I thought I was very stupid. I honestly thought I was stupid. As soon as I started dancing, I knew I was an intelligent being. Mm. And that was amazing for me. Mm. And it was really, and it's a totally different connection to life. I feel like when I'm, you know, as a mover, I'm absolutely in life. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? And therefore, because I'm connected, I'm intelligent.
Right.
It's really wild. Whereas any kind of disconnected kind of approach to life in any kind of way, I'm like, I can't find my place.
Yeah.
So it's given, I know it gives me, even every time I move, it has me make sense of what it is to be here.
Dancers really do, are involved in many of these four factors that we know engender brain health and cognitive health. It is very social. It certainly involves a lot of intellectual challenge, I should say. I'm not sure most people realize how hard it is to memorize all of the dance moves, the facial expressions, the limb movements, and so forth. So it's very cognitively challenging. It's certainly very aggressive exercise. If you sit close to dancers or stand close to dancers, you get to hear how tired they are. And dancers tend to be careful about what they eat because their body is their instrument, as people say. So I think dancing is really got a lot of pluses on each of these four factors that engender cognitive health and brain health.
To me, that's a fantastic focus because you're not focusing on the patterns that you have, because all of us have patterns of moving, and if we just focus on that, we get stuck. Mm-hmm. But if you focus on the flow of energy within the body, mm-hmm. you can forget about all of that and just, like you're saying,
right.
discover. Like yeah. literally, every time anew, you discover what it is to move.
Yeah.
So it's not an end-gaining thing of trying to look
right.
a particular way. But to me, it's about the very thing of discovering in the moment what anything is. You know, and that to me, is that's what it means to be alive, as far as I'm concerned. So when I teach, I'm really trying to focus on getting people to, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
To keep it new, to keep it ever new.
Yeah.
Not by doing new things all the time necessarily, but just to keep surprising and to keep people like waking up kind of.
Animal studies, we know that there are increases in neurotransmitters that allow neurons to communicate, like dopamine and acetylcholine, increases in nerve growth factors that are neuroprotective and engender a number of structural changes, like the birth of new neurons from progenitor cells or adult stem cells, and in some regions of the brain, especially the hippocampus, which is a region that helps us to encode new memories, especially episodic or relational memories. We also found from animal research that to the extent that animals are exercised, usually in a running wheel or a treadmill, they have additional synaptic connections, that is, connections among neurons that allow the encoding of new information, learning. And then finally, exercise engenders new vascular structure, the creation of new capillaries to support increased neuronal firing, learning, and so forth. And from the human studies, we found that both children and older adults, and everything in between, tend to have larger hippocampi, again, which leads to better memory. They have larger regions of the basal ganglia, which has a lot to do with learning, and they tend to learn more efficiently. And they tend to have better connected neural networks, and we know this from analyzing functional magnetic resonance imaging data that's associated with better memory and decision making and so forth. So there's a nice synergy between the animal research and the human research, of course using different techniques. The advantage of the animals, of course, are that you can really delve down into the molecular and cellular mechanisms. The advantage of the humans are that you can ask much more involved questions and get sophisticated answers. But in both cases, there are dramatic changes in memory and decision-making and all of the supporting structure and function that underlies them.
I mean, I don't know about other people's experience, but I know when I started to move, I was like, this is what we're supposed to do. And it was because, you know, we as children, of course you move, that's how we learn. As children, we're learning by moving. And then all of a sudden, you know, you're put in these schools where you're told not to move anymore. So to actually get in that studio and be able to start moving again was like, yes, of course, this is me. You know what I mean? Yeah. This is us. I mean, it was like us, it was me, but it was us.
Right.
That we're moving animals.
Right.
And the fact that we're stopped from moving is like, to my mind, it's a terrible, it's a transgression that shouldn't happen. I mean, I know some people may be more inclined to moving than others, but I think we're all movers.
Yeah.